small footprint. Johnny's been through here. Lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid.
You're a bucka? A Luton? Ah, a godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything, from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? This where you live? Cozy burrow. Good location. Must know about everything that happens in the bog. Doesn't bother you having monsters for neighbors? You know the kids from the clearing well? Don't be afraid. Not gonna hurt anyone. What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess.
Watch out!
Stay close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb. This bottle.
A pack of pickled peppers by the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a cloth. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How do you lock someone's voice in a bottle? Just wondering.
As am I, especially as mine's a voice to crown all voices. Sometimes it's like a forest brook, at others like a roll of thunder. And let's be honest, I talk enough to fill three barrels or more.
Somebody used some powerful magic on you, as a prank or just to be mean. How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sicking their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Oh, I thought not. So it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise, downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's huts, quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice. So I don't think she heard me.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me!
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
What do you know about the crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel. Vindictive. Not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice. Might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty. Although, they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word. But you must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something. Or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers. And you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her. Got my ways. So be it. You helped me and I'm no bore. Come with me. It's clear, not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her. Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Pop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I'm a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did, though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran. But this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No. It is not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Perhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good, good lad. Though the ladies don't like him. No. Foul creature, they say. Don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power o'er all, beseech I thee. Answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
Someone speaking through you?
Good looking and clever too. Where have you been hiding, boy?
I'm looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
The young woman. She's my daughter by choice. I raised her.
If she's shapely, what does it matter?
Matters to me.
I believe we've hit a nerve. You bubbling like well-fed yeast. Oh, that's how I like him.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts? Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Down Warren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we will be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight-errant, or a witch-hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Down Warren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
A dagger? What for?
When the alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger!
And you, White One, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger. Place the alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear, stone shear, stone nose, stone ears.
Hey!
must be coming home from war.
The spark expired.
Come on.
Blow yourself! Get him! Come on!
Greetings. Nice village.
Aye.
A real pearl of the swamps.
If you say so.
You get by all right?
Aye, winter to winter. Somehow we survive.
Recognize this dagger?
Aye, master. I didn't know you belonged to them.
So you know who sent me. Good. Easier that way.
Forgive me. I didn't know you came from the Ladies of the Wood.
They help you often?
From the time of his cutting, every man is theirs. They be harsh mistresses, but they're fair. Just. Demanding they can be, but then nothing in life comes easy. Who drove off the plaguey heirs? Who gave us seeds to plant? Round the other villages, they be eating the soles of their boots, whereas we, well, we get along well enough.
Ever meet the Ladies of the Wood?
Never. They only shows themselves to the Chosen. Perchance one day, I too will be summoned.
Hear about an ashen-haired woman meeting the Ladies of the Wood?
Well, I ain't heard nothing about that. Beg your questions to the ladies, and they may answer. They knows all that happens in Velen.
They got informers?
The woods listen for them. A lone word at an ill hour can arouse their wrath, but they hear pleas and prayers as well. Once a swineherd lost a sow, sat and cried at the crossroads. The sow ran out of the trees as if chased by a devil. straight to the Swineherd.
I'm supposed to help solve your problem. Tell me what it is. Just the essentials.
The war awoke an ancient power. An evil one that feeds on bloodshed. Nightmares haunt our nights and days. Folks sleepwalk from their homes, never to return. Under the tree on the Whispering Hillock they lie. Unburied all. Fathers, sons, daughters, and mothers. Folk are afeard to move them. You must go there. The dark powers must be cast off.
When did all this start?
3 years back. I remember, 'twas a warm day. Went to check the snares for game. Pulled a hare from me trap. It grew dark all of a sudden, though it was nigh on noontime. Thought it was a storm at first. A squeal pierced the air, near burst me ears. The hare rotted in me hands, and the leaves shriveled and yellowed, though it were yet the start of summer. Times have been ill ever since. Folks' teeth turn black as charcoal. Womenfolk fight like polecats, bawling and brawling over nothing. The young'uns, born crippled, lame, fear and cursing. Long have we pled for the lady's help.
Need more details.
You must see for yourself. Me grand's mum whacked me crosswise for straying near the Whispering Hillock. But what happens there now's a wonder.
A few times folk from round here gather to chop down the trees and burn the cursed soil back to use. None returned. The ground neath the weeds is white with human bones.
Ladies of the Wood don't know what this power is?
They know all. Old Thekla claimed they'd be punishing us. Folks stop respecting them. Some even call them witches. But must not be they, for they sent you.
I'll look around the Whispering Hillock.
You be careful, Master Witcher. Don't ye treat this evil light.
Let's go! Run, Roach.
Be gone. Come no closer.
Not so fast, Roach.
I know whence you come.
Faster.
The powers that protect me, they sense whence you come.
Of power.
To nature, to the forest under earth. All death is alive. Every death is equal. I cry. I wail. None is.
Who are you?
I abandoned my circle, where I kept the balance. The crones killed me and cursed my quest.
Never heard of a druid circle in Velen.
I wander eternally through a maze of vows, helplessly sliding over rust.
You must know the crones pretty well.
They are Velen's curse. They hear all through severed ears. They weave hair and twist lives. They take their strength from a broth of human flesh.
Why did they kill you?
The crones want this land. They'd rule the wood alone. I stood in their way. I had to die.
I was attacked.
This is my prison. A fortress besieged. Murderers I await. And my forest protects me.
Murderers?
Murder sisters. Killed my body. Now my soul they hunt. For I defy them.
You claim to be imprisoned. How so?
I am bound here. In fetters of magic. I wandered endlessly. My loved ones of thieves. The children. I know all. I know what awaits them. Free me, please. I must help.
If something threatens the orphans, I'll help them myself.
The children of Antigua. Free me, please. I come here, Gael. A gallop unchained. I shall save them. Only I can.
Why do you think the kids from the meadow are in danger?
The sisters took them. They shall not return.
Where'd they take them? I can help.
It is done already. It cannot be undone. There are no rules to art ceremony. They shall all die. Let them be saved.
The crones. What do you know about them?
The sisters are older than the oldest trees. Velen is their realm. All life here serves them. The sisters live concealed. You will not find them. They hear all. You cannot hide.
I saw women, children even, lying dead on this hill. Do they want to destroy you?
To nature. To the forest of my crown.
Save the orphans from the meadow. I'll help you.
I will find them. Free them. Open the door of my cage. Blood is my escape. A rite you must perform. With the black of raven feathers, the white of my bones, and a swift steed. A mare wild and free. In meadows past you caught. Dark as a bottomless well, black as the depths of night. Such a beast, no other. Gather these and bring them here.
Got some raven feathers.
Find my remains and bring me a mount.
A winged barn steed, a black squall.
Why do we need a black horse?
The beast and I shall be as one. As when I lived, we shall be a gale. Nothing to stop us. A wild steed from meadows moist.
Where'll I find your remains?
My bones? They lie in a solitary mound nearby, due west.
I'll gather what I need to free you, then return.
Gather and return. To the Ilamic's depths, to the tree's rotten heart. Pierce my heart. Let blood flow to be born again. I must first be consumed.
Go now and return through the passage I have opened.
Damn, you're ugly.
Looks like rain. Strange bones. Don't seem human to me. Slower.
Give me up.
Ready. We can start.
Let me fly high, raven wings. Lay wings amidst the feathers. Place all beneath my heart. My heart you must pierce. And bring the steed.
Saw bodies of women and children in the woods. You've killed people who are no threat to you.
The wood killed them, for nature is blind. Death is never more than death.
I offer raven feathers.
Once I was free. I'll be free once more.
I offer your remains.
Once I was flesh, I shall be flesh once more.
Give Crow Perch a wide berth.
I'm busy, busy, man. Got any victuals? Hungry like a wolf.
Solved your problem. Just in case, though, avoid the Whispering Hillock for a while.
Cannot be. Where's something lurking there?
Believe me, you don't want to know.
What have you done?
Didn't have to fight anything or anyone. I simply freed the spirit.
You did what? Freed the evil so it can prowl the world as it will?
Did what had to be done.
And if it returns?
Ask the ladies of the wood to help. The crones, or the ladies of the wood as you call them, said to remind you about payment. Take it, you know what they want?
Aye, I do. Give me the dagger. Be back soon.
There's payment. Take it to the ladies, will you?
What the hell was that?
'Tis our pact. You're a stranger. You don't know life here. It's honest pay for their protection.
So, all those ears in the woods?
Put it out your mind, master. You soon be leaving and we must tarry on. Our young'uns and their young'uns after them. No gods nor masters watch over Velen. The land is no man's. He who wants to survive must seek his own protectors.
happen, young man?
In real life, you're different than you were in the tapestry.
Well, bring it here. You disobeyed us once more.
We are forgiving creatures, but you allowed the children to escape.
They never wanted to flee. They liked it here. They played.
Your punishment must be harsh. Now silence! We must speak to the white-haired one.
The woman who cares for the kids.
She's a debt to pay. She is here by choice.
She's insane.
She knew what our pact entailed when she made it. We helped her. She promised to serve. Now she bears our mark. Belongs to us. Come. It is another woman who interests you. Speak, white-haired one.
You looked different in the tapestry.
We're all dressed up just for you.
If you only knew how much time we spent in front of the glass.
Do you desire us?
You know why I'm here. You know what I want.
You shall dream of us. And return for what you reject. They always come back.
You used me to tame the Whispering Hillock. A lot of work.
Not free, brave soul.
Did you destroy the evil powers? Have you brought peace to our domain?
I freed the spirit trapped in the tree.
Hear that, sisters?
Traitor!
She took the children! Brought her!
We made a deal. I was supposed to help the villagers. I held up my end of the bargain. They're safe now.
So, a mockery you chose to outwit.
Whose spirit was trapped in the tree?
That of one who once cheated death. You freed an ancient power. It will rise again. Elsewhere, beyond our reach, blood will flow once more.
What foolish things men sometimes do.
Our deal. I did my part, now you do yours.
A word once given, we never break. The girl. Mousy blonde. That's what they call it.
Thin as a rail. Terrified. Exhausted. She could barely stand, the poor thing.
We cared for her as best we could.
Like she was our own daughter.
Wasted affection. She proved a very naughty girl.
Mischievous, stubborn, and selfish.
The young woman I seek never hurt anyone without cause.
You've not seen her long. She's changed for the worse.
Why'd she attack you?
She's no longer the girl you once knew. Wrath consumes her.
don't believe you. They say you always keep your word, so tell me everything, exactly as it happened.
We shall tell you, brave boy. We knew someone suffered from one. We let beast entrails, saw the omens.
We would glimpse her likeness, a mirage in a flood. She came from the lower swamp. We knew not at first it was her the omens had spoken of.
A child of the Elder Blood, the sole seed that would burst into flame.
She fell into our hands. Elder Blood!
The blood of the traitress. Does she sleep?
Like a lamb.
Come, sisters, no point in dawdling. The table's set. The cauldron bubbles.
We cannot! You know she is meant for him!
Imlareth will get her. He will. But not whole.
Well said. We'll just have a sample.
I'll take her feet. Lovely. Plump. Perfect for a broth.
Oh, I can taste it already. Very well. Get on with it! You'll regret that, girl. Regret it dearly.
You tried to kill her, tried to butcher her like an animal and eat her.
Her blood, the taste brought back the memories of our youth.
Elder Blood, extraordinary girl, but you know that. Such a shame she fled.
She escaped you, but I'll find her. We'll come back here together and kill you.
Your return, you shall. Our fates are bound. And one will die, but it shan't be one of us.
Now you shall chase shadows and wander midst fog.
Each time you see her, she will be a mirage. And if you find her, If the girl will die to see you, handsome knight.
Looks like rain.